the observatory started, or activity on the hill where the observatory is located, started more than 50 years ago, back in the mid-1950s, when Lincoln Laboratory needed to do work associated with radar, in particular with radar for detecting intercontinental ballistic missiles and various things associated with the Cold War.
Now, in those early days, Haystack was actually built by the Air Force as a communications facility, and I was actually around when it was first dedicated, and somebody had a little TV dish, and they said, well, what are you going to use Haystack for? We can communicate using this communication satellite. And the Air Force at that time said, well, maybe there's general research work that could be done with Haystack. And that's exactly what happened. A huge, powerful megawatt transmitter was built to do planetary radar, that is, to bounce signals off primarily Venus, Mercury, Mars. So that was the big thing back then, and this was in the late 60s, early 70s, was planetary radar.
So now we have multiple facilities on the site. Some of them are Lincoln Laboratory facilities because they maintain a strong presence at the field site, and some of them are Haystack Observatory facilities.
Since its inception, Haystack has been known for the 37-meter antenna and the iconic Haystack radome, but Haystack is a lot more than that, and scientists and engineers here are involved in a wide range of different types of radio science. We have two antennas that are used for atmospheric science. We also have another smaller radome that contains an 18-meter antenna that's used for geodetic science. Haystack also participates in radio science facilities located around the world, places like Chile and Australia, for example.
So when people normally think of an observatory like Haystack Observatory, they think of something that operates in wavelengths of light that you can see with, because most people are born with a sensor that sees visible light. However, here at Haystack, we actually look at the universe through a number of different wavelengths that are far outside the range that human senses can directly measure. To do that, we need these things called antennas. They're very large pieces of metal, and they act kind of like the lens on a normal telescope, and that they focus the radio waves in a particular direction down to a point where we can put a piece of electronics that can sense them. For the work we do here at Haystack, the antennas have to be very large for two reasons. Not only because we're trying to collect very faint radio waves, and so we need a very large collecting surface, but also because those waves have a size or a wavelength that's much, much bigger than the normal optical waves that we see by, and antennas get bigger or smaller as the wavelength or the size of those waves. So we actually have very large antennas here. One of them is about the size of a soccer field, and we use those to sense very, very small waves that are either generated by the natural environment or that we make by bouncing a very large signal from the ground off the environment and recording the little faint signal that comes back.
So at MIT Haystack, we are advancing science in many ways. Even the average citizen is able to help us do science with tablets and mobile phones that are in everyone's pocket. So how does it work? We are trying to get to the point where we can image the entire ionosphere of Earth in order to detect interesting phenomena that are either based in space or based on Earth, like potentially monitoring tsunamis and earthquakes. To do that, we need people donating us bandwidth and transport data via mobile phones from different sensors. So imagine going from hundreds of sensors to billions of sensors.
For myself, I find Haystack Observatory to be a wonderfully exciting place to work and a tremendously rewarding place to work because of the people here and the consistent, sustained enthusiasm and sheer competence that exists here. I learned a tremendous amount within 6 months of walking in the door. And that fact alone speaks volumes about what Haystack is. And it's really remarkable to see that that community and that quality of people sharing their knowledge and integrating people into the Haystack culture sustained over decades. One of the things that I'm committed to as director going forward is to make sure that that culture, that community, continues to thrive, because that's ultimately where the excellence of the technical and scientific work at the observatory comes from.